Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron Mackenzie Lafergy. Ah, oxygen. The eighth element of the periodic table, creator of ozone, protector of the world, the only thing standing between our fragile existence and a dark, eternal slumber. Where was I? Right, oxygen. Oxygen is pretty darn important to us living things who breathe this stuff, so we're pretty dependent on it. But what if half of it up and disappeared one day? How might this affect humanity and the world as we know it? Let's explore. If you'd like to hear more wacky hypotheticals, check out our Biggest What Ifs playlist on the channel. But for now, take a deep breath, because it's time to ask a question. What if Earth lost 50% of its oxygen? There are a couple different ways in which this question could be read. First, it could be referring to the oxygen atom, which is found in pretty much everything, including the human body. This would be pretty devastating. If 50% of all oxygen atoms went away, we would die, animals would die, the ozone would go to crap, a bunch of water would turn into hydrogen gas. It would not go well, and frankly would make for a pretty short video. So for this video, we'll focus on what would happen if 50% of the oxygen gas, or O2, disappeared. Sound good? Good. Let's rock. Currently, 21% of the gas found in our atmosphere is oxygen, the second most prevalent gas after nitrogen. For the record, that's 2 quintillion pounds of oxygen. That's 2 with 18 zeros after it. Yikes. However, if we suddenly lost half the oxygen, we'd be down to a measly 1 quintillion. Which, okay, still sounds like a ridiculous amount, but it's still a lot less. So what would this mean for the world? Well, the good news is we would still be able to breathe. First of all, there is a significant reserve of oxygen on Earth. That's just chilling out, waiting to be breathed in. There are plenty of microorganisms that don't use oxygen at all, and there's a significant reserve in the ocean. Plus, as we all know from studying the carbon cycle in school, plants would still be around, taking in that gross, gross CO2 and spitting out the sweet, sweet O2. All this means that there is plenty of oxygen around to keep us breathing for quite some time. In time, setting all other factors aside, oxygen levels would likely increase, just as they did the first time around. But what about the ozone layer? That's something I'm vaguely aware of, thanks to Al Gore. Well, since we're talking about oxygen gas, or O2, this means that the ozone layer, made up of O3 molecules, will not be directly affected. However, that doesn't mean the ozone layer will remain unchanged. See, ozone is produced in the stratosphere, the second closest atmospheric layer to the Earth's surface. When solar radiation strikes oxygen gas molecules, or O2, it can split the two atoms apart. And when these single oxygen atoms collide with another O2 molecule, they merge to become an O3 molecule. Why am I telling you this? Well, if there is less O2 in the atmosphere, then there will be fewer oxygen gas molecules to be split by the solar radiation. This means that by halving the amount of O2, you will also be reducing the amount of O3, or ozone, in the atmosphere. But hey, you might be thinking, who gives a gosh darn about the dumb ozone layer? I mean, you might use more colorful language, but come on, this is YouTube. To which I would respond, well, hey, you silly willy. The ozone layer is super important. You see, the layer of ozone around the Earth helps to protect all of us organisms from harmful UV radiation. Currently, it manages pretty well. Sure, we still get sunburns and skin cancer, but this is relatively rare. But with less ozone in the atmosphere, these problems would be exacerbated greatly. However, it should be noted that even if the ozone layer was half as thick, it would still be thick enough to protect us from the lethal UV radiation. Thankfully, over billions of years, the ozone layer has thickened considerably. Just 600 million years ago, there was only 10% as much oxygen in the atmosphere as there is today. So going down to half will still be better than that. This leaves us with a bit of breathing room. But just because it won't kill us directly, that doesn't mean it won't affect us. With half of our current protection against UV rays, related diseases such as skin cancer would skyrocket. We've seen this to a lesser extent on a much smaller scale today, with the hole in the ozone layer over Antarctica affecting more and more areas. But the hole is still relatively small. If we lost half of the ozone, it could become a much more worldwide problem. Local and systemic immunosuppression rates would go up, and malignant melanoma caused by indirect DNA damage from UVA radiation would cause countless deaths. Cataracts and other vision issues would also become far more common. This would mean that going outside unprotected would become much more dangerous than it is today. Gone would be the days of basking on the beach mostly nude. You'd want to be covered at all times, which would be pretty rough in humid climates. Sunglasses would be essential in pretty much every situation as well, and society would likely move indoors even more than we already have. Of course, it's totally possible that this sudden drop-off of oxygen would have sudden, devastating effects of its own. The vacuum created by the sudden loss of matter could pose significant problems, and the delicate balance achieved over millennia could be thrown off, to the point where our atmosphere failed to function properly. However, I have neither the time nor the scientific expertise to really delve into those possibilities right now. If you'd like to learn more, Google is your friend. And now we've returned to our question, what if Earth lost 50% of its oxygen? Well, while we'd still be able to breathe, the changes to the ozone layer would result in a host of negative effects due to increased UV radiation. These effects would likely cause a shift in society, at minimum changing how we act and dress outside, and at worst, causing us to avoid going outdoors whenever possible. Bottom line, oxygen is important. Yeah, mind-blowing, I know. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe and all that jazz down below. While you're down there, let me know what other science-y questions you'd like to see on the channel. Now, before I go, here are some of my favorite comments from my last video, which just so happened to be my first video back on the channel. I really appreciated all the kind words. Anyway, Thor McLongshaft says, "Ah yes, the soothing tones of a long-forgotten voice. Thou hast been missed." Well, thanks. There were actually a lot of comments saying my voice was soothing, and I'll take it. Nice name, by the way. Cesar Mata asks, "So why did you quit law school?" Well, because I realized the law is boring. Seriously, if you don't want to spend hours a day reading dreadfully boring stuff, do not go to law school. Make audiobooks instead. Still lots of reading, but much less soul-crushing. Albeit less lucrative. Well, that's it for today, folks. So until next time, I'm Ron Mackenzie Lafergie with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.